Since you are watching this video, I guess your computer is running with an issue here as you are trying to open a program that recently installed. This error arrived. The phone can start because FMOD.dll is missing from your computer. It's a somewhat critical error and all you need to do is watch this video patiently and follow that method on your computer. Hello everyone, welcome to Tech Evolution. In this very short video, I'll be fixing this error within 3 minutes. So, start the counter. The first thing you need to do is open your favorite browser and search for fmod.dll. You can choose any result you want. In this case, I'll be choosing the first one. This is not sponsored, but I'll put the link in the description. Here you can see few download options based on the architecture and version. To know your computer architecture and version, click on start and search for system information. Here you can see mine is 64-bit and I'm recently updated to the recent Windows update, so I'll be downloading from the top. I strongly recommend you to read this page. It has other fixing method also. You can try that too. As the download complete, hit open. The downloaded GIF has two files. One is a DLL, other one is readme. To move the DLL, first open this PC, then new volume C, Windows, and find a folder named system32. This is the home of 32-bit DLL files. And click on the downloaded GIF, drag the DLL, and drop. I have already done this, so it is asking me to replace. And click on continue to give administrator access. Before we proceed, let's check. By typing the entire file name, you can see the file is placed in the 32-bit folder. So job is done for 32-bit users. You can go and restart your computer. This is only if you are a 64-bit user. So open this PC one more time. Local disk C, Windows, and find a folder name syswow64. This is basically the home of 64-bit DLLs. And similarly, drag and drop. In short, 64-bit users need to place the file in both system32 and syswow64 folder. Check this one more time. Similarly, by typing the file name, you can see the file is placed in the 64-bit folder too. And finally, restart your computer. In extremely rare cases, if the error still occurs, you need to download and install latest Windows update and install your program again, and that will surely fix it.
And that's all. If you follow me step by steps, you'll no longer have that problem left. Please let me know how you feel about this video. And do not forget to like and subscribe.